It's been like maybe 2 weeks since I played this game. I did play a little bit on my own and looked around. I found a few things, but I'm... So I'm gonna go, I think, with what I was told that I should probably head back to this area because there's a lot of quests I can probably do in Driftwood. And what's gonna happen now is most likely what I'm gonna do is record a lot of stuff and cut out a lot and try and show videos only where I make progress and less of a little exploration things. Because this is going to take forever and I'm going to do probably longer sessions and it's going to be easier for you. So I was told to look around where the fishing area was, so I guess I'm going to head there. So you may not see videos for a long time, but those videos themselves will contain a lot more things in them, I guess you could say. That's how I'm going to try and approach this one from now on. So hopefully I'm going to make a little bit more progress as I go along. Less walking. Mostly dialogue and actually exploring for certain things. So with that expression out of the way, I'm going to find out what I can do around here still. I don't have the commons up, which I was supposed to do, but whatever. I'll still try and figure it all out. Alright, so just a note here is, apparently this dog is staring at something under the building, and I remember that part, but it's like...
The dog stares at a spot beneath the building. A low growl in its throat.
You see, that's the thing. I'm looking here. There's nothing under this building that I can tell. And the only way I could think of getting in there is if I was a dwarf, but I don't even think that's going to work out very well, will it? Because I've zoomed in. Oh, that's a nice place you are there. Because I'm looking. There is nothing down here. Even pressing Alt. There is nothing down here. So I'm not really sure what this dog is finding. Which part underneath the building are we talking about? Is there a secret entrance or something? Because I can't get there at all. And this is why I kind of abandoned it, because I was like thinking, what could it be that this dog is staring at? And it's supposed to be under the building? I guess, I get it's a hint, but it's like, what type of hint is this even? There's a pile of fish here, that's not going to give me anything. There's money, thank you for the money at least. But otherwise, you can't get down here. So I'm very, very confused as to what this dog is even sensing at all. And I've checked these barrels, there's nothing there. So that's just it. What am I looking for exactly that the dog can tell that I can't? There's not very many places I can even go here. Look around at, and this is where I got stumped last time. You can't even really head down to this area. Can't really head down. There's nothing here that I can see. And you would think maybe, just maybe, it would be somewhere else down here. Because that point is you can't do anything. I've tried so far. I've tried. I can't get to that point. Like it's like down here in the middle of nowhere. I don't know. I'll continue to look around a little bit and see what I can find. Even pressing Alt does not give me anything though.
The chest won't open. It doesn't open.
Speak the word, and I
shall. Oh. That's what he meant about chess, the sleepy adventurer. Wonder aloud the box didn't just speak to you. This thing is speaking?
Speak the word, the magic word, and I shall open.
Okay, let's try mother.
No.
Okay, open.
No.
Unclose.
No.
Reveal.
No.
Scourge.
Still no.
Go to counterintuitive, try close.
I am already.
Try the ancient closed. Word for open.
I did not. Understand.
Try chest.
I am a chest.
This one?
Is your buffalo unwell?
Okay, we could probably get nowhere doing this.
Yes, you could.
Swear of frustration.
Do not profane. Speak the word, and I shall open.
Wonder a lot if you're not onto something of a loser here.
This seems likely an excellent choice.
Okay, I don't get this thing. Hold on.
The man sleeps on.
Mother, I have no words for that.
Kick his heel.
Huh? What?
Asking for the word for the chest.
He wakes. Thief. Mother, there's a thief.
He settles back to sleep.
Tell him you want the... Stroke his face and tell him you're his mother, asking for the magic word to his chest.
He snorts.
Mother, it's so obvious. Speak the word, and I shall open.
Maybe that's what I'm supposed to say.
Then goes back to sleep. The chest sits there, refusing to open.
Try the word.
You speak the word. I open for your safety.
Well, apparently the word was it.
Stand back.
Stand back.
The lock unlocks with the tiniest click.
I got a lot of experience doing that. And what do we get? Bane. Ooh, look at all this. He doesn't even give a shit, does he?
The man slumbers on.
Let's say thanks for the stuff.
He stirs.
That's nice, mother.
And goes back to sleep.
I guess the quest is done, right? I mean, I figure I'd do something. It gives me some experience, doesn't it? Not enough to level up.
Of course it's
Is it marked as done, I wonder? Speaking of four tongues, we're going to open the chest. We found the magical bridge. It demands a password. We kind of did that already. Oh, a magical burning chest. It demands a password. Oh, that one. That's a different one. What about archived? I don't even know. Oh, this new the adventure. It's closed. All right. Well, that was just kind of a side quest. So let's see if I can find a next quest to do. I'm going to do this step by step from things that look like they can be done. Nope.
Of course it's not true.
Find a Surrey family crypt. That's in the other place there. Black Pit. So hey, those people have no idea. Shadow over Driftwood. That's something else. Investigate Lohar. Lohar's the different... Has had difficulties associating mortals. Maybe we can exploit this. We made contact with the Lord Crime Lohar. Master Julian asked us to investigate Lohar's doings in Driftwood and its connections to the Dwarf Queen. I don't know how we're supposed to do that. So maybe I should pretend to be a dwarf or something. I'm not even really sure.
And you can't be too careful.
I'm not sure at all. I'll go and meet you when I find something else interesting.
Doesn't this room strike you as eerie? There's a chill in the air, a deeper darkness in the shadows. But, of course, I should hold my tongue and stand guard. All's well as long as my lord's coffered. Better watch yourself, lad. Got greedy eyes on you. Sets me on edge.
As you approach the silken robed noble, Ifan does a double take and laughs in recognition. He pulls you to one side.
Well, we got Ifan talking to someone.
I know this man, and he's not at all what he seems. A moment.
Let's wave him ahead.
Ifan bounds forward and embraces the man, all effusive greetings. As they part, talking animatedly, the man's beard slips sideways down his face. He's wearing a disguise. Ifan laughs as he straightens the beard. They chatter away for some time, using a guttural cant you struggle to understand. At one point, the man says something and looks over at you intently. Ifan waves his hand and laughs.
Let's let them continue.
The man hunkers down.
I'm not going to start being rude.
Sketching a rough map on the floor, using an apple, some playing cards, and a fistful of threads.
What is this, the MacGyver version of a map?
Ifan claps the man on the back and turns to leave.
Do we get any info?
Well, now we know the way to the sawmill. And we know Roos thinks I'm bringing you there as part of the Godwoken contract.
Uh-huh. Let's talk to you.
Roost camped out at the sawmill.
Roost is at a sawmill.
Yeah, we were looking for that guy.
Let's pay him a visit.
Let's grin and nod.
She smiles. Her eyes are dark pools.
This could be something good.
Must be an awful lot of fun toys to be had at a sawmill.
I presume there is, so I guess we'll head to that sawmill then. Well, I gotta leave this area first, so I'm gonna look at my map and I guess I'll try and meet you there or something. Good thing I talked to someone here. Actually, this room here. Before, let's check if there's any. This looks like it could be interesting. And if I can lockpick it. Open lock. Pick. Let's pick it. Probably not level enough. And if I pick it, will they try and go after me? Thievery too low. Well, I ain't getting in here, so. I'll meet you elsewhere.
Of course it's not true.
What a shame it is.
An absolute shame.
That's what I'm talking about. What a shame. You know, I guess I'll see their dialogue.
Alexander, slaughtered like a supper lamb. Poor dear.
It ain't right.
It ain't right. Never thought I'd say this. I hope they round up them sorcerers for good. I ain't needing one sick in a void working on me.
You said it, Hilga. You're a true patriot.
Hilga jabbers excitedly with Brax, but the two go quiet as you approach.
Of course it's not true.
This town is poor, but this room is rich.
A weathered woman in a dirty sea captain's tunic babbles breathlessly to herself, and somewhere nearby, you hear a bell ringing.
The bell rings a warning and the tide is on the turn, and I without my compass.
She held a compass. She must have been the captain. Ask where her ship lies, Berthed.
The ship is in the locker, on the bottom in the rocky shallows, and all are drowned but me.
Mm-hmm.
And yet, can you hear? The bell rings on. The bell haunts me yet, and it would drive me mad.
Till I hear the bells in the in Cruel After Two.
I'm haunted by my crew. They ring the bell to drive me mad. Please make it stop.
Uh-huh.
She buries her head in her hands and cries.
Make it stop.
I wonder. Oh no. What the? Why hear the voices?
Of course it's not true.
Who are you? Spirit of Seaman Stubbs.
A ghostly seaman stares at the captain, his lip curled in a malevolent grin, his eyes wide with hate, and all the time he rings his
bell. He's the one doing it.
He registers your presence. His head swivels towards you.
Spoke to the lady captain, didn't you? I seen you cozying up. Are you hers, you bag of bones? Or sail you with us?
Tell him it's time to set sail himself. His life is over. He can go to the Hall of Echoes.
I'm doing my duty here, I am. I'm the lookout and I'm ringing
the
bell.
Oh, I see what he's doing.
Rocks ahead, Captain.
I'm usually good with Constitution. Praise him for his sterling performance of his duties. Tell him he's earned shore leave. Dag nabbit.
His lip curls over his blackened teeth, and with a smile, you know you've lost the argument.
The only one who has a good one, I think, is Ifan, I
gave. The bell with renewed urgency.
Rocks ahead, Captain! Avast! Hard aport!
Might make a save here, in case I fail with Ifan.
I'm ringing the bell! Turn the ship before it's too late!
The bell rings on.
I'm going to do a quick save here. Usually Ifan has the persuasion, I believe. That's the wrong button I haven't played in a while.
Take the wheel, Captain! Take the wheel!
His persuasion is at 3. I would need to give him another one. Oh man. And the persuasion levels are kind of weird.
The bell still rings. Do you hear it? Do you hear it?
Rocks ahead, Captain. Do you hear me?
A ghostly seaman's.
Are you her man, or sail you with us?
Of course it's not true.
Then you won't sail with you. Ran the ship upon the rocks, Captain, and all the crew were drowned. I'm doing my duty here, I am. I'm the lookout, and I'm ringing the bell.
Oh, that one worked.
But I'm on duty here. There are rocks ahead, and the Captain must know.
Tom, he's relieved.
He blinks once, twice. A single salty tear drips from one ghostly eye. The bell falls silent. He raises a finger to his temple in salute and fades away.
Ifan, you magical bastard. It's gone.
She babbles breathlessly on, barely aware you're there, and nearby sounds a ringing bell.
My ears are still a ringing.
Tell her there should be no more.
And I have you to thank for it? Then thank you, I surely do. That accursed bell lies with the peacemaker on the bottom in the rocky shallows. My compass lies
now
there.
Now about ask about her compass.
The compass surely lies on the bottom, near where the ship was wrecked. Take it with my blessing. If you can
I actually use that compass?
My sailing days are done.
Ask for the location of the wreck.
Let me mark your chart.
All right, cool.
But you be warned. Stay off the wreck itself. Let her lie as a monument to her dead crew and as testament to my mistake.
Sounds like a challenge. Ask her what happened to the Peacemaker's cargo, if there was one.
She goes white as the proverbial ghost.
You've got no call to go looking for no cargo. Far as anyone's concerned, we sailed with an empty hold, and if there's anything left to salvage, you leave it where it is. Heed me. Leave the cargo of the Peacemaker alone.
She turns away. Conversation over.
Oof, get a reward here. Medium wits potion. Stardust herb or medium fire resistance potion. Let's try this one. Well, it wasn't much, but it's something at least. Well, that quest is over, so I guess we can maybe go and try look for a few things now. I don't think there's... Until I figure out what to do here, there's not much else I can do, so let's skip to somewhere else.
The lizard looks at you with undisguised fury, and then doubt.
You don't look like a magister.
The hell? I just warped here to Cloisterwood and I'm right with her? Tell her you mean no harm.
I've heard that a lot lately. It's always a lie.
Under her breath, she incants a simple spell. No sooner does a portal open beside her than she steps into it and is gone.
The hell? I did not mean to actually warp here, by the way. That was bizarre, but am I stuck here now with these dudes? I don't want to fight them. Am I stuck here? I don't think there's a way out. Oh, then no, there isn't a way out. How do I leave? How do I leave here? Or is the electricity gone now? Are the magisters still here? Oh, they just moved over. Okay, I will make my way out then. I'm not ready for that at this point.
Go no further. We are at ritual. Do not disturb.
I found this place randomly. I realize a sawmill is not a good place to go. What if I have her? Seville. Would you like to see the trial? Say that you have gravely important matters to attend to and must be allowed to pass? I don't know. There's nobody to be defensive. You mean no harm. I know it's not going to work.
The elf shakes his head slowly, his eyes fixed upon you with a stare of a hunter.
This place is not for you. Leave.
Okay, fine. Well, I'm going to do another save here. And figure out if I can even do anything.
Go no farther.
Go no further. We are at ritual. Do not disturb us.
All right, constitution persuasion with her works.
Your tongue betrays you, sister. You spend too much time with humans. But you may enter.
Okay, I have no idea what this is about even, but let's figure it out then. Something new, actually. I was going to go somewhere else, but... What the hell is it? Like a map here.
Three battle-weary elven warriors make ritual over the body of a fallen comrade. They're chanting low and fierce. The pain of their losses manifests in every word.
Blood to earth, to wood, to birth. The blood of Sarius to this earth.
Let's whisper the refrain, blood to earth.
The tallest, strongest elf, whom you take to be the leader, acknowledges your presence with the tiniest tilt of her head, then turns back to the task in hand.
Well, it's something.
She places the tip of a long-bladed spear on poor dead Sarius's chest bone.
Blood to earth.
Her companions reach out and grasp the spear, ready to plunge it into Sarius's heart.
Let's go along with the ritual. I don't know how this is going
to
go.
Blood to earth.
Together you plunge the blade deep into Sarius's heart, then twist it three times, as is the custom. Blood flows freely to the ground, and Sarius's heart lies neatly cut in four.
Blood to blood!
What type of ritual is this?
Each warrior plucks a piece of heart and places it in their mouth.
Okay, well, I mean, elves seem to do that, from my understanding.
To see what you will do.
Let's eat the flesh.
Sarius's memories flood.
I might as well get her memories and see what happened.
Proud and true, you fight the lone wolves at the sawmill for Sahala, your scion, and for the future of all the elves, or all that still remain. But the fight goes ill.
Okay, so the lone wolves are the people at the sawmill, and that's the problem. That's who we're after with her.
You and Tova draw fire, that your friends may flee. You die in Tova's arms.
You and Tova draw fire. Give Tova a slow nod of respect. You share a memory now.
With the barest blink, Tova accepts your good wishes, then turns back to the corpse.
Sarius is a warrior, proud and true. Blood to blood, earth to earth, wood to wood.
Okay, now you're just saying things to things. Things to the same things.
Sarius becomes his tree. May Sarius take root.
The elves pick Sarius's bloody corpse from the ground.
Down in that hole?
Tova looks to you, then indicates for you to help. Together you send Sarius to his final resting place. His corpse rolls to a stop at the bottom of the pit. The elven
stands rough.
And stares at her fallen comrade. Then she wipes away a tear and turns away.
Whoa, damn, and I only get one of these goddamn things. Damn, that's strong. Iron Greaves, maybe? With that? Too bad I can only take one. Alright, we also got a Poison Wave Scroll. We got another Ancient Amulet. Gives a lot of magic armor. I gotta figure out the runes. 1100... Well, that was something at least. Should I talk to some of the people here, maybe? Especially as Seville.
The tall elf stares into the pit with dry, bloodshot eyes, her face betraying no emotion.
We lose too much. We lose our homes. We lose our safety. We lose each other.
She looks into your eyes, her face set in a fierce frown.
It is enough. No more.
Tell her to understand she feels you have lost too much yourself. Tell her it's time of great loss. No escape. No one escapes untouched. Let's be an elf.
Yes. It is as though Tyr Syndilius himself forgets us. There is no fate for us but the one we make. You honor us during the ritual. You honor Sarius. You help remember him. You help bury him.
But we need help still, or we perish here. Not only these people here, but all of us.
I wonder if you honor us once more.
That's what she needs.
It is something of great importance to me and to our
people. Something I can actually do.
Our home forests are gone. The great trees are cut to pieces. The memories inside them nearly lost. They become nothingness unless we find our Sion.
We've heard a sign before. Ask after the sign she seeks. What's their name? Where were they last seen? That's Alfred.
Not lost. Taken. All our memories. Everything the ancestor trees knew. Our seed for the future. Stolen from us.
Is this something you gotta consume to get the memories out?
She.
Yes.
She is.
Her voice catches in her throat.
She is my daughter.
Uh-huh.
Her name is Sahela, and she is taken from us.
We know where she
is. That is why we come here. That is why we lose Sarius, to find her. If she is lost, if our Sion is lost...
We know where Sahela is. This is part of our quest.
She is everything.
Her eyes narrow, her fists clench, and her mouth tightens to a thin line.
Do you know the lone wolves?
Nod.
Then you know the risk. We come here to get her back, to bring her home.
Sahela?
She is everything to me. She is everything to us.
Sahela said you met her daughter while you were in Fort Joy.
You do. You speak to her. Then you understand. You see what a gentle soul she is. You see how kind. She is not only a Sion, but a precious child. She cannot be lost.
Well, she's not lost. We know where, if I say I'll find her then.
You honor. I fear it is impossible for one of my kind to enter their base. They know we are here. They expect us. But you have been away from the tribes. It is in your speech. It is in the way you walk. Perhaps you have a chance still. She is taken by their leader, a savage man named
Roost
Anlon. I do not know why, but I know she must.
But are you saying that she was...
If I lose
take
her,
it from Fort Joy?
I cannot lose her. We plan another assault. We cannot give up. It is better for us all to die than for Sahela to be lost. I only hope perhaps you find her before then. Good luck.
But we know where she is, right? Rescue Sahila from the sawmill. She's there? She came she tried to come back? Is that what happened? Is this part of the other quest though?
Once all are well, once more we take
cattle. And kill the lone. I got burn the bird. That's gonna give me some free experience though. I should do that soon. Quickly. I have no idea if that's even part of the quest we had before. Archive, maybe? Yes, we found Sahila's people. Now Sahila's taken. Okay, so that one's closed because... Okay, so we're on the right track for that. The sawmill, though, is not going to happen. I can tell you that right now. They're too strong. So... I was actually on my way to another place where I accidentally encountered here, so I'm going to go back to what I was actually doing.
Dark all of a sudden.
Oh my god, no! Out of there! Out of there! Holy shit, don't go there. I've been doing a few other things, but goddamn, do not go in there. We were in a bad spot. I mostly just done some exploration. I'm cutting the videos into parts at least so that I can kind of separate them just in case. It makes it easier to sort out a little bit. Still looking for that thing though that we found before.
Something.
Tell the dog that you're running away too. Said you don't run away from anything. You run towards things.
Like sticks. Bulls? Understand. I understand. I run away from bad man. Very bad man. Man wanted to make me spider food.
Spider food?
I know. I can sniff good and bad. Riker bad.
Riker? I thought this Riker. It sounds like someone to steer clear of.
Bad man. So bad. I liked his house. Big garden of stones. Lots and lots of bones to dig. Good, tasty bones. But when I sniffed him, how he is for true, I ran and ran and ran.
That's just me.
He pulls a few tentative steps closer and sniffs all around you, nose wrinkling with concentration.
Smell not like dog, like wolf, but not bad like Riker. Good wolf.
He bounds forwards and licks your face effusively. His breath stinks of graveyard clay and ancient bones. Immediately, you feel an allergic reaction developing on your cheek, hot red blotches spreading in an angry rash. The dog scurries away to sniff about the area, leaving you with his approval and an itchy face.
How did you get diseased? I'm gonna bless him. Oh man, that's not getting rid of anything though. The hell? How do you get rid of diseased? How do you get rid of diseased? I don't even know. He's gonna die at this rate or something. This one, get rid of diseased. Your mind? No. How do you get rid of diseased here? He's not dying, but still bad. Do I have a potion I can give or something? Gareth? What the hell?
Gareth toils in monotony.
Not the mounds of dirt. What's going on? It's, he's alright. It's not like him to be so sullen. Which is so great. Is he putting someone down or digging someone up?
Gareth freezes, then turns slowly towards you. His breath so steady, his voice a monotone.
I'll have to insist you show some respect, Godwoken. I'm putting my murdered parents to rest.
Gareth moves to continue his task, but his cadence falters. He pauses. Silence hangs, begging to be broken.
Apologize, I had no idea.
No, of course you didn't. Godwoken, I've seen Seeker's blood seeping into the sand. I waded through corpses on the deck of the Lady Vengeance. But when the lifeless eyes looking back at you are your own mother's, I just didn't know. I didn't know what darkness lied beyond pain.
Wonder who could have done this, maybe.
Now, well... Now I do. Dallas's pets. Such helpful tools they are, too. The abominations do the dirty work and the whites keep their robes clean. Convenient. They're still there, spreading their rancid smell through the house. Paladins came to clean up the mess. In the name of Lucian, they say, and they seem to believe it.
Gareth shies away from you. His eyes pass over the half-filled graves, and he takes a shuddering breath.
I'm the one who's prayed. An endless litany. How many pleas does it take? How many tears do I have to shed? How much must I lose for the gods to listen?
Gareth forcefully exhales and looks past you to the nearby house. You fear he might snap the shovel's handle in two.
Let's try another point. No, I would not. Spirits here are troubled. Tell him to think carefully about his next step.
I've no use for empty platitudes. Not from a walking skeleton chosen as the Seven's divine pet.
You swear you hear Gareth's pulse, galloping faster than a saddled mount. You've never heard such a thing before, but you suspect Gareth's heart is close to tearing.
If you want to help, then you find the craven wight that ordered their slaughter. Anyone that stands between you and truth, no matter the flag they fly or creed they follow, make them bleed!
Okay, shake your head. Is this what these parents have warned for to succumb to in Brow of Rage? Nope.
You know nothing of my parents!
His hand moves from his shovel to his sword. He wipes his forefinger along the blade, opening a bloody gash. He stares at the wound, then wipes the blood across his glistening forehead.
Do it, or don't. First I lay my past to rest, then I see justice done.
Show your weapons. I don't want trouble. Let's try with him. Okay, I'm gonna reload the save and try that again with my better person.
Besides, what's the alternative?
The two paladins Gareth mentioned are arguing in front of the door to the modest farmstead. As they notice your arrival, they stop talking and look at you quizzically.
Oh, that's what's going on.
We're guarding this house. Wise to stay well back. There's a bunch of silent monks inside who've tasted blood today. Already killed in there, so they did. They didn't kill anybody. The magisters who control them did. You know Donna, she wouldn't hurt a fly. Not until they turned her. But they did turn her. And now she's not Donna anymore. Get it through your head. The poor creature should be put down. No, wait! Surely, maybe someday they can be fixed. When all this source nonsense is over.
The other paladin rolls his eyes and shakes his head as he turns to face you.
In any event, it's our business, not yours. You just stay well away from the door and you'll be perfectly safe.
Tell them not to worry, I'll take care of the silent monks.
You can't do that. They were people who were loved. It's not right to butcher them like cattle.
Let's try constitution. Nope, needed five.
Back off, man. Can't you see he's upset enough about Donna without all this?
Oh, I mean, I could just try and do it my persuasion, dude.
The two paladins Gareth mentioned.
We're guarding this. No!
The other
In any event, it's our business. You can't. They were people who were. Back off, man!
A man paces.
So this
back
is
and
where
forth,
I was intending to find earlier. I had trouble finding it because it's still tiredness. Goddamn disease.
The faint coppery hue of dried blood stains his hands. He sees you.
If you're looking for healing or the like, then you'd best look elsewhere. My plate is full for now.
Let's see. No lingering trace of blood on his hands.
The man chomps on the bit of his pipe, generating a small cloud of nervous smoke. Finally, he plucks it from his mouth and clears his throat.
I came by a new patient, a young woman, very troubled. I'll do what I can for her, but I'll need to concentrate. And that means...
He gestures with his pipe for you to leave.
Let's offer to help.
This isn't someone with a broken leg who needs to be held still. This is serious and dangerous.
Okay, so I managed to get inside last time. I can't remember how I did it. No.
The answer is no.
You know, I think I did it with her.
A man paces...
If you're looking for healing or the like...
The man shot...
I came...
He gestures with his pipe for you to leave.
Let's say that I have knowledge of healing. That's how I did
fine.
It with her.
You can help. Take this key
it was
and
with
go
her.
To the cellar.
Now, I managed
I'll
to do this one.
There.
And just I'm expecting death
be careful.
Of at least one person,
it's
but all I need to do is
sorcerer.
Take her down just a
but
little
also,
bit.
Whatever she was subjected to was warped in body and mind. I have her locked up for good reason.
This is not going to be a typical battle here, so what we're looking to do here is like, yeah. It's going to be an interesting one. We just gotta last for a few rounds, or at least knock her down. And that's pretty much all we're gonna do. It's, I won't say it's tough, but it's not gonna be an easy one, I can tell you that much. Where is it? It is. Where is it? Over here. Into this like cellar area. Now we're gonna have a battle to do, but it's not really with her directly.
Across the cellar, a shape bearing some resemblance her. To a woman like she might lurches around to face you. It utters a marrow-curdling gurgle.
She senses us. Be calm and quiet. No sudden moves.
Let's say this one.
You're right. I hadn't noticed
before. I did not notice that.
Couldn't get close enough. We have to help her. Maybe we can reverse whatever was
Let's
done to her.
Agree to it.
All right. We need her subdued, understand? Do whatever you can to weaken her. Just don't go too far or you might kill her.
I don't think it's possible
Another
to kill her.
Sharper, angrier.
I don't
then
think.
The sound of rapid footfalls rushing towards you.
Okay, so now she's going to summon like these weird demon things too. Floating too. Oh my god. Sibyl's pretty much been destroyed. So now if I can get a little bit closer to her, we basically gotta subdue her, yeah. This is... see? Holy shit. Backstab. Then I'm going to... Grant skills venomous aura, mass cleanse wounds, and evasive aura. Let's see. Yeah, we basically gotta like be very careful here. So what I'm gonna do with her is make her invisible for a little bit. And end her turn. Alright.
She's too strong. She must be weakened.
I know
no
that. Try and mend metal a little bit, actually buff us up a little bit. And then it's gonna be a hard one to get just her. I'm gonna walk up just a little bit, I think. Yeah, I don't know the magic. I don't think I can eliminate her magic yet. Heal Sibyl then. A little bit. Oof. Acid on him. Let's see now. Evasive on him. I can't get to her at least.
Yield to none.
And I guess let's put some blood on the floor. Oh, we can't rain here, actually. Never mind. This is gonna be a tough one, man. It's gonna be actually tough. Blinded failed, apparently. Do this. It's a little bit healed. Haste retreat. There's no high places here, unfortunately. I want to get a little bit closer at least. Do mend metal. Then. Anyone need extra? You do. Okay, he's far away, but he has a blizzard thing, I think. With the blast, and we're all chilled now. Not as prepared for that one.
I need aid.
I know you need aid. I was expected to lose someone. Unfortunately. Just gotta go fast enough to try and get her HP down. Great, he's been charmed. I think I'm gonna fail this one, unfortunately. Damn, I did better last time with her against her. I don't know why I'm doing so terrible now. Okay, I'm reloading. I'm gonna try that again.
I'm ready.
All right, I did it with like no loss this time.
Her breathing and uneven.
Because I just had to attack
Swan's
her.
Swan's satchel of surgical tools lies nearby.
Begin the operation.
Swan approaches, cradling his arm with a grimace of pain.
Those summons of hers broke my arm. I'll do what I can to help, but the rest is up to you. Tread carefully. One false move and she's dead.
I just want to help keep her steady.
Swan carefully holds her head steady with his one good arm. Something moves along her exposed lobe. It's a maggot of some kind.
See, the maggot seems to have a firm grip on her brain tissue. Take a pair of sturdy forces and attempt to remove it. Select a pair of delicate tweezers and gently remove the maggot. Let's try this.
The maggot fights the pull of the forceps and sinks its hooked maw into brain matter. A chunk comes away with it as you pull it off. The woman's breathing has grown shallow as she hovers between life and death. All you can do is close her up and hope for the best.
Remark to Swan.
Swan shakes his head with a sigh.
I can't. The work's too delicate to do one-handed. I'm sorry. I'm not accustomed to being so
then I slowly close
bloody
up the wound.
Useless.
You replace the extracted bone and bind it with copper hooks. Then you draw the scalp back in place and start stitching the incision shut. The woman's breathing grows stronger.
Wow, look at that experience
even.
We just got.
Color flushes her cheeks.
She's alive. You did it. I've never seen anything like that, not in 20 years. I'll tend to her here for a while. She shouldn't be moved yet. She'll want to thank you once she comes round, I'm sure.
All right, can you heal me though? Because we're kind of in a bad state here, you know? Kind of a bad state. Pumpkin, sure. Because he's still diseased. Can you heal me up?
It's a damn miracle that she survived.
Can I even talk to him? You won't heal me?
The young woman blinks as she struggles to focus her vision on you. She looks weak, pale, but already visibly more human.
It's you.
Oh.
I remember your face in the darkness. You saved
me. She used to be a silent monk somehow, I think. That's what happened to her.
The Magisters arrested me in Arx for sorcery. They strapped me to a table. And they put something in my head. Something alive. They put me on a caravan bound for Fort Joy. They said I was going to become a pet for the hammer. I could feel myself changing. I tore off the shackles that held me. Like they were parchment. I remember hearing screams, feeling the blood of others on my hands, in my mouth. Then I ran, and then I woke up here.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. Can you help us?
That was damn fine work you pulled off there. Consider me in your debt. I'll keep an eye on her until she's ready to fend for herself. If you find yourself in need of potions or healing,
yes,
be sure
please
to come
heal
to me.
Me.
It's the least I can do. All right. Hold still now.
Wow. Okay, good reward here, it looks like. Devastator. It's all in. Decapitator. Oh my god, look at this. 66 physical armor. Versus the Devastator, just 40 to 48 physical. God damn. God damn. What do I think defense might be better. They're all epic. I wish I could take more than one, though. I hate that fact that I can't. Well, at least Diffin's finally healed. What about trading? You know, I'm gonna do some, see if I can get any trading done.
I'll keep an eye on her and, well,
and see what else I can get.
Until next time.
Well, the game's saved here. Should I try to attack these Voidwalken or something? There's some creatures here. It's Magister, right? Looks like it. Yeah, a bunch of Magisters here. That's a four. Yeah, maybe I'm better off not attacking them. I have no idea. They're doing no damage to these. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna go away. Actually, never mind about that. I'm gonna try and find something else to do. Oh, there's a prison down here in Driftwood? I didn't even notice that. Well, that's interesting to know. I guess I might as well check it out then. Okay, what do we have here? So we can talk to this guy, Silent Watcher. Oh, wait.
Passions, unblinking eyes regard you from help. Beneath the Silent Watcher's cowl.
Never mind. How about this Magister? I don't think I've ever been down here. This is new.
The Magister turns to you with a scowl. He already seemed immensely displeased, and your interjection isn't improving his mood.
What?
See, claim that you sense the great unhappiness and restlessness of the spirit. There's somewhere he'd be more appreciated. He should go there.
Who asked you? You're not even supposed to be down here.
Finesse? Okay. Need two? Okay.
Keep out of it.
All right, then I'll use Ifin.
The Magister turns to you with...
What? Look around. Would you be happy stuck guarding this bloody place? 10 years of service and they stick me in a hog with a bunch of speechless goons. The new leadership ought to learn to respect its veterans. We're the ones who uphold the rule of law,
he'll be reassigned
like
soon.
Raymond and Jonathan.
A sly smile creeps across the Magister's face.
Aye, and sooner than you might think, if the rumors are true. Let's just say, there's other places where I'd be appreciated more than I am in Driftwood.
Tell him that he should leave then and join up with whatever adventure it is. Or no, that's what other place, let's ask.
The Magister loses some of his bluster.
I ain't saying. It's a secret for loyal members of the Divine Order only.
Okay, fine. Go join up with
Who
them.
Who asked you? You're not even supposed to be down here.
Can I convince you? Yeah.
The Magister glances around the cells.
You only need two, so that's
fine. Before
keys
from his belt and casting them aside.
This isn't the Divine Order I signed up for. Not anymore.
Divine Order isn't what it used to be. Okay, I'll get those keys then, I guess. I don't know what it's for.
Lucky find.
Indeed. I don't know what it's for. Off in here. I guess it's just for the prisons. Mm-hmm. There's nothing really going on in here. Oh. There's a guy here. Name's Grigsby. Wait, didn't I hear about Grigsby before? We don't got much going on in him. Hmm. Who is this? The Silent Watcher. I don't think they care about me. Look like they care about me. Hmm. That's a torture device, I think. Don't want to touch that. Yeah, I don't need any of that. Guess I'll go through everything else I can find. I don't need sheets of paper, man. I really don't. Nah. What's with the glowing here? Tension medium. You shouldn't do anything out of the ordinary. Hmm. I'm not doing anything out of the ordinary, for Christ's sake. What's going on here? It's a sheet of paper. Don't need the paper. Alright, what's all this? Sorcerer's Most Wanted. Mortis dwarf suspect linked to local dwarven malefactors. Last seen Driftwood vicinity. Known since his Lohar searched the area at the Black Bull. Riker, elf. Known lone wolf affiliate. Oh, I remember him. Not to be challenged by our forces of, by order of the White Magisters. Last seen Stone Garden Cemetery. Hanang, lizard. Beware powerful portal magic. Last seen hosted by large family in Black Pits. Almira, human, black ring, last seen captured and taken by white magisters. Sahila elf, blind mystics, last seen captured and sent to Forge Joy. Hey, Ifin, human, lone wolf, last seen captured, sent to Forge Joy. Addendum, there remains suspicion of sorcerer activity on the northern end of the Blood Moon Island. The island itself is currently inaccessible to our forces. So are those the people I should be looking for then? I wonder... I'll give you some free experience at least, I guess. Now, what do I do? I don't know if this actually helps me out with what I'm doing. Oh my god. Level 2 staff. Guess I'll do that a bit later on. And first, I guess I should. Healing advertisements. I don't think it's going to be any good, though. Yeah, unless there's something secret down here, I can't really see much else to look at. Book. Just a book. No, it doesn't appear to be anything here. So, let me look at my stuff here and see. Oh, right. I finally persuaded this guy.
A lascivious smile spreads across his face. His tongue darts from his mouth to lick the spittle from his lips.
Let me ask you this. Across the world, who is renowned above all others for their exquisite lovemaking?
I literally don't know. Is it the lizard somehow? It's all in the tongue. Tongues are far, far the greatest lovers. Human?
Well, I'm sure that in your own case, that sentiment is almost true. Mm-hmm. But no. Let me tell you the truth of the matter, my friend. The very best lovers are, whisper it, lizards. And for a barely significant sum of gold, I can introduce you to the greatest lizard lover the world has ever seen.
You said you had something else in mind?
Well, this is what's available. Take it or leave it. And I suggest you take it. It's better to regret something
you did.
What the
hell is going on? Some sort of prostitution thing?
Do, am I right?
He holds out his hand.
Pay him.
The money vanishes into his apron.
Now, let me ask you this. What flavor of stew do you prefer? Do you like the strong and meaty variety? Or do you prefer it delicate and fragrant?
No, feminine?
If you get my meaning. Upstairs, on the second floor. Her name is Zara. Pleasure is her business. Enjoy the experience of a lifetime.
He gives you a mischievous grin, then dips his head in salute and turns away.
We're really doing this? We're doing this? Okay, fine. We're doing lizard prostitution here. Great. Grand, was I looking for Zara? Maybe. In which room? In this room, maybe? Oh, that's the one. This is why. Now I can get in there. No, I can't. It's locked. Upstairs?
You've got to pick who you can trust.
Where?
Of course it's not true.
Oh, here. There's another upstairs. I didn't see that. Unlocked. Well, let's head up. Okay. There she is. Zara. Have I talked to you before or not? I don't even know. Well, I don't know if I'm looking for her, but hey. Let's talk to her and see what we get.
A lizard, tall and beautiful, turns towards you. She fixes you with a sultry look, and when she speaks, it's like listening to honeyed smoke.
Well, hello there. I wasn't expecting you. Which means you haven't paid. See the man downstairs.
She gives you an apologetic look, then turns away.
Okay, it has to be one who paid.
A lizard, tall and beautiful, turns towards you. She fixes you with a sultry look.
I'm so glad you came, but your friends will have to leave.
She turns her back on you and waits for your companions to leave.
Okay, fine. Keep having trouble always trying to unchain them. See? There we go. Guys, let's go. I have no idea what's going to happen here. All right.
A lizard, tall and
I'm so glad you've come. Are you here to
water my flowers?
Water my flowers?
Let's catch her to say yes.
I've been so, so lonely since my man went away to fight the coming war. I need someone to take care of me. You're so masculine, darling. Won't you take care of me?
Ask how she feels as a lizard letting about her man fighting against the Empire.
She gives you a cool look, then a flirtatious smile.
Not in the mood for games. Me neither. So what shall we do? Would you like me to dance for you? Or would you like to hear a poem?
Let's tell her you wanted to hear a poem.
I like a lover who likes the arts.
Here we go. A princess was once locked indoors.
She looks around at the stone walls of her room, then takes a step towards you.
She tended to get very bored.
She arches an eyebrow and takes two more steps towards you.
Stand my ground.
She takes two more steps towards you.
A hunter did save her.
She gives you a wry smile that makes her eyes twinkle.
And asked for a favor.
She drapes her arms around your neck, moves her face so it almost touches yours. She looks you in the eyes. Her lip twitches as if ready to kiss.
And then whispered.
Finish her sentence for her. Lie down. Lie down on the floor. Thank you. Take me, I'm yours. I have no idea.
That doesn't rhyme. And you can thank me later.
To rhyme.
With a smile, she propels you towards the bed. You fall backwards onto the soft mattress. She jumps on you, kisses you.
Look at her in the eyes, touch your beautiful, dive into her, whatever.
She searches your face for the lie, doesn't find it. The compliment touches her. She smiles, reaches for you. She takes you into her arms, into her heart, into her very being. Your world explodes in bliss.
Sex happened, right? Lucky. What? Oh my god. Where's my armor? Hired assassin.
Good morning, lovebirds.
The swaggering rowdy stops dead in her tracks, a look of dubious recognition on her filthy face. She smiles uncertainly, gold teeth flashing for the briefest moment.
What the? Ifan? No little birdies told me you were back in town.
Everyone knows Ifan.
You know Gil?
Wow, Ali. This is why Gil scams, right? Tell you're back and you're looking for work?
You're too funny. Come on, boys. Let's give Ifan some privacy and head on out to wait for the next guest. Oh, and Ifan, if you see any chumps down there who could do with a lighter purse, send them this away, for old time's sake.
Carefully keeping her eyes trained on yours, Jill tosses you the clothes you were wearing. The thugs retreat, each one shuffling backwards with eyes pinned to you the whole time. Zara suddenly looks terrified, not scared of them, but scared of you.
Mm-hmm.
Please, forgive me.
The look on your face says you have to kill her now, as she knows it. Give her a long, cool look, then smile and Leora kiss her. It was worth it.
She's relieved.
It was worth it, wasn't it? Now, baby, you should leave. You don't need a thing like me dragging you down, hanging on to your heart.
She wants to go out again.
She brightens and reaches for you.
Oh, do I? Why, yes. Yes, I do.
Is she naked? I guess. I don't know.
You fall into each other's arms once more. The world explodes in pleasure.
Now what? Hey, at least I got my armor this time.
She sleeps deeply, her breathing soft and regular, the hint of a smile on her lips.
Well, looks like Ifan is a good lover. I guess I shouldn't be surprised in the least. Well, that was interesting. I wonder what happens if it was someone else. Would I have been fucked in the other way, not in the good way? I mean, I don't know what the good way is even. All right, guys. Lucky. Characters, 47 turns. Well, damn, bro. I got lucky. I mean, I don't know how I'm going to use that luck, but I'm lucky. Well, that was interesting. Oh, can't get in there. I mean, I can't even pick it, unfortunately. Well, wait, maybe I can now. I did end up upping my thievery just a little bit.
I'm not in love with you.
Pick lock. Made up my thievery just a little bit. Thievery too low. God damn it. Well, I'll meet you at something else, I guess.
Thank you.
Elfling connects the wisdom of the ages. Learn from flesh and bone left behind. Come on. Fill up on tales new from cultures past. At least not with a belly, but I'm telling you,
if you got nothing to add, you got nothing to add.
Yeah.
He gives you his mischievous grin.
I did promise you the experience of a lifetime.
He's a front man for a scam, asking why he does it.
His lip quivers. You expect him to be afraid, but he's not. He's ashamed.
They have me over a barrel. They do. You have to believe me. It's hard enough to earn a crust around here, and me and the young'un, we've been starving.
That's not the young one.
Oh, sir. The little 'un was left with me when my wife died. She won't make it without me, the poor child.
The child's name.
Livy. The child's name is Livy. She stays in the kitchen while I work. Go look. I swear it's true.
All right, you better not be lying.
I'm not. I swear it.
He gives you an earnest look and shows you towards the kitchen.
All right, Livy. This kitchen. That Livy. I don't see no Livy.
The cook acknowledges you with a small bow. An oddly formal gesture, given the surroundings.
Please, sir, you should not be back here. It's not safe.
Ask me to buy some... Ask to meet Livy, Lorvik's child.
Livy, you say? The child of Lorvik?
Let's say something's quite not right.
Livy was no child of Lorvik's.
Why? Why Lorvik would lie to you?
The cook smiles at you, as if you were a child.
Because he is Lorvik.
The cook slides a wooden spoon into a simmering pot of broth. She lifts out a goat skull, hooked through the eye socket.
This is Livy. Was Livy. Lorvik didn't like goats. Once I'm through boiling her bones, he'll be rid of her for good.
I think it's a way to get your own back on Lorvik.
Good luck to you, but please, I need to get back to work.
Okay then, so you lied to me, and you probably made a daring escape, didn't you? Yep, he's gone. No idea where he ran off to. Well, the only thing I can do is check my... Let's put the thing here. Love has a price. Gone. He fled. God damn it. So basically, I messed up, I guess. I don't know what my last save was. It was too far away. Oop, load. This is the last one. I don't feel like doing all that all over again, so I guess that's done with for the moment. So now, I gotta figure out what else I should be doing.
Grim-faced guard raises his weapon as you approach, then stops short and quickly bows respectfully.
If I'd been missed,
man,
I'd even
if it could get anywhere
didn't
here.
Think we'd be seeing you again so soon, sir.
No, I didn't ask the guard to remind you who he. Ask him if Roost is within.
He is. He'd be glad to see you too. Glad as Roost gets anyway. He's hoping you'll bring friends.
Friends.
He winks at you so hard and so theatrically. That one whole half of his face seems to squint.
Who are you?
You wouldn't remember me, sir. But you saved my life at Tambor Brook. I still have the anky where you stuck my big toe. Roost's upstairs in the big house there, sir. He's waiting for you. Reckon he's as eager to hear how you've been getting on as the rest of us.
Well, looks like I have free rein in the sawmill now. That's good. I just didn't have to sneak in. Going like normal. The elven seer here. Well, that's good. Now they're technically on my side. That's a technical aspect, though. What's going on over here? Lizard. Some woman. Honey hook. Those are some honey hooks over here.
An elegant lizard lone wolf smokes Drudeny through an ornate pipe.
Alright, cool. How about you? What the?
Looking fresh, gorgeous. What I wouldn't give to climb your tree.
Damn. Ifin gets all the chicks, man. And me? I get nada! How about you? You interesting? You got a bow. Maybe he's like a shop or something. It's Fletcher Corbin Day.
When the King of Fletchers takes his...
A thin, grim man carefully sands the end of a beautiful, unpolished longbow. He studiously avoids looking up as you approach.
Moin your way, sir.
Tell him he didn't have the bearing of a lone wolf.
He looks from the ground to the bow and continues standing.
Suppose I don't. I'm no assassin, just a Fletcher. Roost heard about my work and
I see.
Invited me to work here.
Invited with quotes.
He blows a dusting of wood dust off the bow.
Feller doesn't ignore an invitation from Roost Anlon, does he?
Where the bow? Okay, there's supplies.
I'm not supposed to be trading with the other guests. Roost's orders. How about,
tell him you're Ifan Benmezd. Roost won't mind. Heh.
Ifan Benmezd. I've heard about you. Quite a lot, actually. I doubt very much Roosted mind if you had a look at my wares indeed.
Jesus Christ. Just have Ifan talk to everyone here. Oh my god. Basically all for Ifan. I mean, I have a lot of these to begin with, so... what is Sky Shot? Oh, that sounds really good too. I love the idea of a Sky Shot. Sweet Mercy. Punchman Hydrogen. That might be better by a little bit. This armor looks pretty good. This one has... I mean, they don't give as much... Okay, right now... Let's see, if you're a necromancer... Yeah, you might actually be better with this one. No, this one here. It's one plus one necromancer could be good in theory. But let's look at the bows quickly. See what we can get here versus my 25 to 31. Magical Wizard's Bow. Set slow for one turn, 20% chance to succeed, plus 10% critical chance. Life Steal, Necromancer Finesse. A lot of money here. I don't know, man. I'll come back to him. I'll come back. Let's go see Roost quickly. Actually, I don't even know where he is. Where is he even? You know that. I actually don't know. We'll talk to the squirrel. Talk to squirrels and see what they have to say.
My mate Fenerd once nabbed a seed that had fallen on Mummy Dearest's strong chest thing. It was never the same after that. I guess losing half your face does something to a guy. Or so my mam says.
That was British, I could barely understand.
Speak.
No. Take a leave. I want to talk to the squirrel, not you. Or I should talk to my comrades sometimes, maybe. No, I wanted to be him. Oh my god, really, so hard to talk to a squirrel. That's right, I'm chasing a squirrel to talk to it. Come on.
I used to have a sister named Chloe. But Chloe tried to sneak out the back door, and now Chloe is no more.
Indeed, apparently so. Alright, let's go find Roost. I have no idea where this Roost guy is, even. Not sure if I was back there once. There's some weird shit going on here. Someone's been dead void woken. I don't know if they're actually dead though. Okay, Roost is where? Where are you?
Well, maybe I'm just horny.
What? What did you say? I thought she said maybe I'm just horny or something. Well, she is apparently. She wanted to climb up Ifan's tree. Fire water. What the hell?
Hey, it's a good living.
Apparently it is. I guess it'd be... I thought these were doors. Where is Roost? Oh, that's an inside. That's Mummy Dearest. Talk to Mummy Dearest.
A compact, heavily muscled dwarf turns from her training. She flicks her wrist and instantly her axe, a stunning elven weapon, is a hair's width from your chest. The blade sings.
Let's marvel at the beauty.
She gives you a long look, then relaxes. The blade moves back an inch.
That blood belongs to its original owner. It adds character. I look forward to adding Godwoken blood to the mix.
That's cool. Let's put the contract out on Godwoken.
Mind your own business, mate.
Not that the weapon is not normally meant to taste its blood's owner.
It will if you swing it at me. It's especially if you're an elven raider with more enthusiasm than skill.
Can I try it?
No, you can't. I can sell you all manner of weapon, elven or not, if you have the gold.
Note the dried blood
upon the
blade.
This axe ain't for sale. That belongs to the original elven owner. Doesn't it add character?
Well, let's
all
trade.
All right, we're done. Bugger off.
Man, more stuff here. 31. Ooh, these are actually fairly decent. If I'm not aiming for... God damn it, look at this thing, but it's so expensive. Wow, these pants, it's still so expensive. And that's on special already. Oh, damn, look at these helmets. Oh, man, I'll never be able to afford any of this right now. Even with all the trading I can do. I mean, there's not much to trade yet. Yeah, I'd have to trade a lot of stuff to get, you know, I'll come back.
She returns to her training.
I'll come back. Let's go find Roost. That Roost. Slumberjack, what the heck? Look at this guy's HP. What?
A lone wolf mage naps quietly.
Laugh all you want.
Okay, I got a load of save, man. I'm loading my save. That was bullshit. I'm redoing that.
Lone wolf mage naps quietly. She talks in her sleep.
Laugh all you want, Mudbarrel. Madmen tell tales, and dead men's ghosts do not.
Shake her awake.
She turns towards you. When she opens her eyes, she's looking right at you.
Mudbarrel can't have his money. I hid it.
She closes her eyes and settles back to sleep.
That didn't do much. Can I get
she
any more?
Mutters in her sleep.
I never liked you anyway, Mudbarrel.
Mudbarrel, I don't
you
know who this guy is.
You are shite sense of humor. Don't think you haunt me, dead man. You are the Godwoken that we killed.
This door looks like it leaves nowhere anyway. Oh, it does lead somewhere. Okay, so I think what happened was we got caught with her training or something. That's what I think happened. So we're not going to bother with that. Okay, where is Roost? I really can't find this guy. There's a bunch of traps here or something. I don't know. Where is Roost? Well, I might just have to look around myself to find him and figure out where he is. I don't know.
Hey, it's a... You know that. Your living is nothing if you're...
Okay, there's a second floor here. I didn't have to go out that far, actually. All right, Roost, are you here? Oh, shit, there she is. Shadow. Well, I guess I'll do another save here. Oh, wolves.
Sibyl grabs you by the arm, her nails embedding themselves into your flesh.
That's him. That's Roost, the man who abducted me and sold me to the master. This is it. He knows where the master is.
Try?
My thanks.
Sibyl walks up to Roost, a massive man who's looming over a small elf, his hair a tangle of matted knots. Scars upon scars cross every inch of visible flesh, from his hands to his gnarled face.
Roost, Anlon, I've come to ask you a question.
His smile is nauseating.
You'll have to give me a kiss first. Lots of tongue, too.
Yeah.
He laughs, the sound of a hiccuping demon choking on raw offal.
How vile and petty a thing you are.
Shut up. It's her I'm talking to. Sibyl, I was wondering when I'd see you again. Knew the time would come after you broke Daddy's leash. Ha ha, yes. Been wondering when the master's little pet would pick up my scent.
Let's urge her not to take the bait.
I know.
She winks at him.
Let's try that again, shall we?
Her casual dismissal of his insults seemed to unsettle him somewhat. Uncertainty sours his face.
How about we just cut to the chase? You are searching for your master. I know where he is. Them's the cards we're holding, and I've got all the aces up my sleeve.
A flash of the needle. With lightning speed, Sibyl spears his hand. He
oh
howls
boy.
With pain.
Strange. I see no cards whatsoever. The master. Where is he?
Let's see. Tell him it's probably best to play along now.
Not that you have to.
She twists the needle, making him squirm and scream.
On the island! He's on the island with no name!
That's not helpful. It's got no name. How do we know where to go?
Good boy.
She removes the needle. Roost suckles his wound with
thick, slurping noises. I'm surprised the people here did not do anything.
Where is the island? Tell me.
Oh, I'll do you one better. I'll take you there. I'm going to beat you like I did before. I'm going to bleed and bind you and what's left of you, no more than a battered bit of meat. I'm going to deliver to the master all over again. He'll be so glad to have his puppy.
Oh, I feel like we're going to battle
even
now.
Even if she'll have lost some of her luster.
Oh my god, we're bad. We're bad. We're bad. Maybe I should have. Wait. What level? 14. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna load. I'm gonna let Ifin do the talking this time. How about that? Let's see what happens when Ifin does the talking. I don't think I'm ready for her to continue with her quest yet. We're gonna try and get Sahila out of here. They seem to like to take elves. I guess they're like slaves to these people. Alright. We want Ifin. I forgot I didn't have if I had Fane somehow. Okay, so I decided that's not happening now because I don't see a way I can actually get Ifin just to talk to her unless maybe I took her out of my team and made her way outside or something. I could try that out. Seville, get out of here for now. It might be for the best. Why is it so hard to get her out of my team? There we go. Okay. We're gonna try this then. That's the only thing I'm gonna do. See what happens if it's just.
A massive man looms over a small elf, his hair a tangle of matted knots. He slurps something into his mouth.
It don't work. For me, anyway. You try.
He offers her something round and slippery, like a wet, white marble in the palm of his hand.
I do not defile the dead.
Ain't you an elf?
We eat flesh to honor it. Not to steal the secrets of the dead.
Secrets, secrets, they're no fun. Secrets, secrets, hurt someone.
Ifan clears his throat. Roost turns his face to you both and roughly wrenches the elf's jaw towards you as well.
Well, look at that, elf. The silver claw is
silver
back.
Claw, that's his name?
Ifan, old boy, you're losing your bloody touch. Your mark, Alexander, still
draws
breath.
Why does everyone think he's dead?
And my sources tell me he's headed somewhere called the Nameless Isle. I'll be setting sail there myself any day now to take him out. Your failure has put the reputation of
all
wolves
at
stake. But I suppose I might be swayed to forgiveness by the other little Godwoken morsels you've brought me.
Stay away from the Godwoken roost. They're mine.
Step up to Roost and demand to know who issued a Godwoken contract.
Roost looks around shiftily and pats his pockets, but ignores your question.
Mouthy ones, aren't they, Ben Mezd? Must have been a long journey here.
Step back a bit if it handle this.
Ifan steps between you and Roost, head high and hands wide.
I can't let you take them, Roost. You know me. You know you can trust me. So believe me when I say this is bigger than any contract.
That's not how it works. Let the rest of the world worry about right and wrong, good and evil. We've always had a narrower focus. And that's not about to change now. We've had good times, Ben Mezd. We've had bad times. But this is the best time of all. You just dancing a contract right into my lap. What else are friends for?
Roost moves to lunge at you. But Ifan is quicker. With two steps and three stabs, he slows Roost down just long enough for you to draw your weapon.
Oh, we're going to fight anyway. It doesn't even matter that. Doesn't matter what happens. Hasted. Well, that sucks. I'm going to use this thing again. God damn it. I'm not prepared for this, so we're not even going to bother. We are going to not deal with this one right now. I'm going to try it another time. When I'm actually feeling up to the challenge, level 14 too. Yeah, so definitely not gonna do that right now. Let's try something else. Okay, so I can get onto this boat from there using tactical retreat. I had to read that comment, but the problem here is how do I get the bridge down? Unless because the boy's supposed to be distracting them. See, I'm not really sure. Now I'm alone as Ifin. Very much alone as Ifin. Does it matter if I open it up or not?
I need to get clever with this lock.
See, I don't know. Oh, someone's in here. Hello?
And who are you? Oh, never mind, no time. Hurry on in and gear up. There's a void woken right out the front door.
Let's say we met her son on the other side.
Barin? He's still out there? Damn it, I told him to go back into town. We gotta do this fast. Let's get those bugs out of here. You in?
Grantella, it sounds like your kind of party.
By the seven, that's what I'm talking about. I got all the fixings here for every kind of bomb, grenade, missile, and shell you can imagine. Make what you want and then let go. I got a boy to get back to.
Okay. But I'm supposed to somehow open this thing up. Oh my god. I mean, ouch. Ouch.
Ready, set, squash.
Oh Jesus. I'll fire now. Over here maybe? Over the bridge? Good. Everyone. Let's get over there, everyone. That was the best I could do. Ifrin's kind of in a bad spot now. Alright, so. Not everyone's ready to fight. And I guess Ifrin has to, like. Actually, that was a bad idea. In theory. Let go of Ifrin! Ifrin's cursed. Stop it! Stop it! What the hell? I'm just getting everything on Ifrin. Bro, what the fuck? I can't do it. They're all aiming on Ifrin. He's gonna die. I can't help him. Jesus Christ, finally. Why is... Okay. Now... Apparently invalid target. I can't rain blood anywhere here. Oh, that's blood sucker. For Christ's sake, I'm gonna have to redo this, I think. I thought the boy was supposed to be distracting them, but apparently not. I don't know, man. I really don't know. I think if it's gonna die now, I have no other way to help him out here. Let's see. What I could do is maybe put you to sleep at least. Good, you're asleep. Okay, and then what? For Christ's sake. We're too far. We're way too far here. Well, that sucked. Okay, you know, I'm gonna try that again. That was bullshit. Because they all basically just attacked Ifrin. I thought the boy was supposed to be distracting them. But apparently he wasn't. I literally don't know how I'm supposed to do that without Ifrin getting hurt. I finally did it. Yes, you have earned a hero tag. Specific options will be available from now on. Well, I lost. I'm losing all my people here, though, because of this goddamn fire. Oh my god, everyone's dying. I win, but then everyone died! Everyone died. I need resurrection scrolls. everyone literally died. I can't use anything right now, though, apparently. Do I have the... Bane? Okay, that's why. God damn it, everyone died, for Christ's sake. Everyone freaking died. I hope I have enough resurrection scrolls, though, because... God damn it, man. Use. Cast skill. On you. Red Prince? No, that's not who I want. Red Prince. That sucked. Everyone died in the end, for Christ's sake. Now I have to use all my resurrection scrolls, unfortunately. Jesus Christ almighty, everyone died. I'm pretty sure I have at least a few more here. Right. What happened to all this stuff here, though? I don't even know. Yes, Sybil has two. Jesus Christ, everyone died. Everyone died. That's skill. Everyone died. I might retry that battle because that was annoying. Yeah, I should have rested everyone like right away though. That might have been what I should have done. Oh well, let's just see what happens now, I guess. And I'm gonna end the recording here. I got like 3 hours of footage today. I might redo that battle. Where is everyone? Oh, here they are.
Fit as a fiddle. And what's the size?
I might try that again.
Spider monkey doing safe and sound.
Spider monkey? You mean dragon?
Come here, you.
Mother and son fall into a tight embrace. One tear rolls down Mari's nose, falls on the black stubble on Baron's head. She strokes the wet drop away.
Happy to see them reunited.
Mari seems oblivious to you. Her eyes are closed, her lips turned in a serene smile as she strokes Baron's head.
My boy, my good. Good boy.
Hey, wait, one sec. Ma, look. I don't know where you came from, but that was amazing. Thank the gods everyone's all right.
Thank the gods. Oh, thank the mum and our friend here too.
That's us. We're glad to help.
I know a good arm when I see one. I'll tell my cousin Raymond what you did. He's real high up in the order, and he's visiting Driftwood as we speak. Could be he has some good work for you.
Let's see. Say you'll go now. The house surrounded by corpses of Voidwalk, and it may not be safe.
Reckon there's space for us in the Magister's barracks. Raymond ought not to turn down his own cousin.
How about this one?
Don't I know? They're a jumpy lot these days. Voidwoken have got all us sleeping with our weapons in hand. Can't fault them for wanting to protect us. Raymond's a good sort. You'll see.
I don't like him. He's mean.
Oh, from the mouth of babes. Well, you don't have to be nice to be a good sort. You'll see. I'll tell him what you did here. He'll be grateful.
Well, have we rarely seen boy walking in one place?
Some dwarves, locals, attacked a Magister caravan. Must have been sorcerers inside. Voidwoken must have sensed them. Came in formation like a proper battalion. Never seen anything like it.
You're lucky to survive.
Mari looks to Baron and flexes. He does the same back at her.
Luck wishes. We're off into town. Best of luck to you, mate. And come say hi if you make your way inside.
Oh, man, that was tough. And these are not really as worth it, I feel like. I'll take the boots, even though I don't feel like that's good. So I'm going to do a quick save, and I might retry that battle, though, because I feel like that was awful. Awful, because that hellfire thing. And if it's hard to make if it stay alive, I find. Well, at least I know I can do it, so just in case. But I'll end the recording here and see what I have, and we'll see what happens.